Welcome back to Quinoa Paw Creations tutorial videos, and today's video is going to be a demonstration of how I do my peyote stitch edging on a medallion that I recently made. So to start the medallion, I have my beadwork done, and I have about a quarter of an inch of pellon all the way around, and I have markings on the top, bottom, and the sides, quartering up the circle. I will start my peyote stitching edging with one row that starts the middle of the design on the top center. That one row is going to go over the edge, and on the back side I go through right at the end of the row and come through the front side a half a bead away, so that I'm in position to start the next row. So I get my needle as close to the beadwork as I can so that it can go around the edge, and I'm going to start with one bead to start row two of the peyote stitch. So we're going to go through that second bead. This peyote stitch is done. Going every other bead. So we put on a bead, went through one bead, and then put on another bead, and then just continue that peyote stitch over the edge of the medallion. Always pull it nice and snug. Continue that peyote to the back side. And then on the back side, we add another bead. We put a bead on the front and a bead on the back. So whatever you're doing on the front side, you do with the back side. That will give you some idea whether you're doing that row right. So when I come from the back into the front, I'm going to come up right where that bead is that we just placed on there, because we're going to use that bead to start the next row. So you're going to be adding a bead every other row, and then using the bead you added on every other row. So we go through the bead we added, gets us in position to continue row three of the peyote. So I add a bead in between the beads that are sticking out, just like peyote stitch, and continue across the edge. And the form markings are quartered up that circle so I can hopefully get my design to work out. So going to the back side of row three, we will be using the bead that was placed before, just like we did on the front. So we're going to go through that bead that's there. We get that tightened up nice and snug, and we're going to go back through to the front side right where that bead is at. When we come back up, I have my needle slanted, so I'm coming up a half a bead space away to start the next row. In the next row, we will be adding a bead. So add a bead and go through that second bead. And that's a good foundation for your peyote stitch edging. So it's gonna just continue. Continue all the way around to the back side. And use that bead going to use that bead from the previous row to end it. Oh, I'm sorry, we're adding a bead. I'm sorry, I apologize. So when we add that bead, we're going to come back up right where that bead is. Sorry, I can't. And go through that bead and continue the next row. Just making sure that my design is on kind of split in the middle and comes right across the top edge of the medallion. So we just go through and continue on and finish that rope. I don't usually grab out a pattern. I kind of just make it up as I go along. But I could certainly make the pattern for you if you're interested. So go through that last bead from the previous row. And make sure it's all tight and snug and go right where that bead is at to the front side. And we used the bead, so now we're gonna slant the needle, go over to where we can add a bead for the next row. Use that second bead. Start their next row. And continuing the peyote stitch makes it nice clean edge, keeping it nice and snug. It's now become my favorite edging because it looks so much cleaner and tighter. And on the back side, you want to make sure you stay in line. So you're going to make sure it stays in the line there so that's even all the way as you go along the edge. So I added a bead and go from back to front, right where that bead is that you added on the front side to start the next row. And make sure it's all nice and tight. Go through that bead that was added. And you're in position to start the next row. Really does look nice and clean and tight. Continue on with the peyote stitch. And then I will do 1/4. I go from the top mark, the mark that's on the top in the center, and go down to the mark that's on the right hand side. And however the design turns out, then I'll continue that. So there we go. That's the peyote stitch edging. So continue that design all the way down to the center mark, keeping my lines in the back straight. It's a nice clean edge. Finish 1/4 of that from top edge to the side mark, and then repeat that in the next 3 sections. So there's my peyote stitch edging for the medallion. And I hope that you understood and learned something. Thanks for stopping by. I hope that this video was helpful to you. And I look forward to sharing more. Please like and share my videos so that you can support me. You can come by and join my reading circle on Facebook, where I have my live sessions every Sunday afternoon. Please answer all the questions so that I can allow you to join the group. Or you can also visit my website at www.quinwellpawcreations.com. You can see my blog and maybe join my talking circle. I'm going to start a talking circle soon for those that need some support and some connection, for women that are interested. It would be great to have you there. And also, you can also go and scan this code and buy me a coffee. Support me so that I can continue to provide my teachings and educations. You can become a member and support me by buying me a coffee a month. So I appreciate your time and hope that you enjoyed this. So we'll see you next time. Thanks for stopping by.